Have you ever wondered what is this lip flip all about? So the lip flip, just talking about it in front of a crowd of people at a conference, everyone perks up. Oh, the lip flip, I want the lip flip. What is it? When most people talk about it, what they're referring to is flipping the edge of the lip using neuromodulator, okay? So Botox-like medicines that can give a little perk to the lip. It can give that ski jump look because a youthful lip often has that projection. So it can, for many people, adding a little filler to it would be part of a package, but I would say the most accepted is neurotoxin alone. Most clients come in and have filler as well at some point, or it can be a gateway so that people start with it, they're okay with how the lip looks, and then they're, okay, I'll do a little filler, I like the trend. So let's talk about, we now know what it is, let's talk about who should get it and who shouldn't get it. So who should get the lip flip and when should you use it? I think a good use of it is, just like I talked about, a gateway or an introduction to lip filler. Some people are very scared to look unusual. They're scared that the people will know or notice that they had something done to their lips. And this would be a good use of it for a subtle result as an entry point into what the lip might look like with a little filler, because you can't use a lot of neuromodulator or you'll change speech. So it's not something that's gonna last a long time. If it lasts 6 to 8 weeks, that's really good because the average is typically 6 units or so. The next good use, the second reason a lot of people do it, or I might do it for patients, is those who've had filler and they like the way the filler looks. They're not ready to get refilled, but they want a little perk up to the edge, a little more pink show. This is a great use. It might be 4 to 6 months into their filler experience and they want a little pick me up. It's quick, it's easy, and they can do it, and it makes the filler look a little bit better. The third time to use the lip flip would be if someone gets lip filler, but they really want to be seen as having lip filler. They want that look that's a little more dramatic. Using it at the same time, concurrently with the filler, can, at day 3 to 5, kick that edge up just a little bit more, so that it accentuates the look of the lip filler. Most people who would do this are people who've already had a lip filler before, they're comfortable with the look, and they know they want to accentuate their already high ski jump, as we call it. So a seasoned veteran might want them concomitantly treated. Another good use of the lip flip would be if somebody has an event coming, they didn't want a bruise, they didn't want a lot of downtime, and they didn't want the possibility that someone knew that they had something done just before. I think it's very reasonable, especially those people who aren't on aspirin, fish oil. It's very low risk of bruising. It's a very superficial injection. When we're gonna see bruising is if when people try and actually inject the muscle, but really a subcutaneous injection is all you need for this area. So if you want something that's quick, you're in and out, low risk of bruising, swelling, or the other side effects that are normal with lip fillers, then the lip flip might be for you. Okay, so we know why we might use it. When should you not use the lip flip with neurotoxin? The first reason would be someone who wants more. If someone comes in, they want more volume. The lip flip, it's gonna kick the edge up a little bit, but it's not gonna add a lot of volume. They're gonna be unsatisfied. There's not gonna be a dramatic result. So somebody who wants more volume, go to filler first, or filler and neuromodulator at the same time, but it won't give them enough result. The second time I wouldn't use it would be if we're worried about speech, or someone who comes in and speech is their living, or they've never had it before, they're worried about changing the motion around their mouth, or they whistle to get their dog back, or they have to whistle or purse the lip. You're going to lose that with the lip flip. So it might be a time when you don't want to do neuromodulator around the mouth. Filler would be a better option. Another good reason not to use it would be someone who's aged a little more or more aging in the perioral area. If we use it, we might help vertical lip lines. It's a great way to stop vertical lip lines. But if there's no vermilion border to begin with, it will be unimpressive. You're not going to get a lip flip or a true lip flip. You need to have a nice crisp border in order to get a nice looking result. And one way around this could be just adding filler to the border, the vermilion border of the lip, then adding neuromodulator, it's not gonna give the patient a lot of volume, but you need that crisp border, and adding neuromodulator will not create a crisp border, it changes the angle. So that's the lip flip. One of the most important things to keep in mind, and the big picture is key here, is when we talk about lip, it's all about angles, dimensions, and proportion. You have the ergotrid, the area above the lip. You have the edge of the mouth, the downturn, the depressor anguli oris that is part of the lip because it's pulling the edge down. You have the upper tubercles, the two upper three tubercles and the bottom two tubercles of the lip to think about filling. The angle of the cheek, nose, and chin, all those projections are going into the mind of your injector as they're recommending, do we do a lip flip, do we do filler, or do we do both? So it's much more complex, and studying beauty and studying angles is a big part of it. But the lip flip can be a very rewarding procedure when it's used appropriately. Now we know what it actually is and what it can be combined with. How do you use it? Do you like it? Pop over to Instagram. We have a lot of before and afters over there. Also subscribe to the YouTube channel for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.